here in these times. This
no, it's okay. They're not photos of little boys.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, good point. Okay. So that brings it to Zaldin's turn. Sorry for attempting to skip you.
Yeah.
As fun as that would be. I'm Splinter. So wisdom saving throw on your part.
Classic Zaldin.
Yeah.
All right. I assume this isn't a spell.
Correct. It's power. Divine power.
All right. That's 21.
Nope. Not enough. Are you immune to psychic damage or anything right now?
Not right now. No.
Okay. So you take 100 points of psychic damage.
Cool beans.
What did you just say? And you're
stunned for one round.
Did you say
100 points?
Yes.
That's not a real
So Kenna, from your perspective, now you get to see that whole like time fuckery thing where you could jump back and forth in time. Essentially what it is it takes your brain.
I assume I can take my legendary save on this, can I?
No, because you can't use it on divine powers.
Yeah.
It's like taking like your soul and attaching it to a rubber band and just like whipping it up and down in the time streams.
Oh, that's interesting.
So, yeah. I mean, for someone with a really good memory, it's very interesting, honestly. Because I actually, you know what? For the hell of it, because of this unique situation, give me a perception check.
See how much you remember?
Yeah, honestly. Or just retain. Like, just to see what you can actually see.
24.
All right. You see this battle play out in like a couple different ways, like several different times. It's not just Zaldin. It's Zaldin and Advitticus. And a couple times it's Zaldin and Rosalina. And a couple times it's Zaldin and Holonoxian. So he seems to have a connection with those three.
Hmm.
But that's what you remember after your brain comes back and you took 100 points of psychic damage and you're like, ow. Yeah. And then for his second action, he's going to Divine Blast you, which is another god power, which all intermediate deities get. So he basically just like holds up his hand and like essentially a timepiece appears in front of him and it just gets like really big and just smacks you in the face. For future reference, when you guys get Divine Blast, you can have it look however you want. But let's see. And it's an at 20 on the roll, so that's going to hit you.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
That is pretty much how the way things go, apparently.
Goodbye, Kenna.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, this is an ouchy ability, too. On the bright side, you're not on your home plane.
Yeah, damn it. I think a really cool power, power, I guess, for you to get Kenna would be, like, convert any attack spell into fire. And, like, use it as, like, a counter spell. So it's, like, if you can read that they're just gonna, like, oh, lightning bolt or whatever. Oh, no, fire, please. And then just take it.
That would be cool.
Mm-hmm. So you take a total of 88 points of radiant damage.
All right, so 1/4 because of the Shadowfell.
Yeah.
So 22 damage. Which is enough to trigger my self-immolation contingency.
Nice.
It's a good contingency.
Yeah. Oh shit, I haven't used that in a while.
I'm on fucking fire.
It's not gonna do as much because of fire damage is also 1/4.
Yeah.
Let's see. I don't have Xanathar's Guide open for some reason.
Is Kenna still around?
I am probably still around, yeah.
Okay, then you get laser beamed.
I've got okay. Xanathar's.
So, 26. Does that hit
nope.
you? And then for his final bonus action.
Oh, no.
Fucking attack like 4 times in one turn. Yeah, Jesus. Rough.
He's going to shift 100 feet back. Straight back.
Is that, you're not dead yet? Shit.
No, he backs up and he's like, He's attempting to, like, basically distance himself from Kenna because he knows that Kenna uses standard spells.
Yeah, I want to... Can I use my reaction from the laser blast to phase shift?
Yeah,
that's what I want to do that. So I'm... away. Just away.
Yeah, yeah. So, I mean, if you shift away, he won't actually shift back then. He'll actually stay there.
Okay.
He just, like, sees you disappear, and he's like, flee, coward. He'll actually shift 100. Actually, he'll just land on the deck of the ship, seeing as there's no one else on it.
That's mine.
It was yours.
You motherfucker.
He took it. Everyone else fled.
You want to fight me for my ship?
Technically, I'm still standing on it, just in another... totally a reality.
No, I know. let's see here. So that brings it to Brock's turn. Oh no, sorry, 300. It's the Sharisha's turn. He technically was before you, and I just fucking forgot to roll for him last time. So he's actually going to do.
Okay. Yeah.
He is really frustrated that you one embarrassed him, and then two. Didn't take any damage from him after he dropped the deck. So he's going to start off with two claw attacks. Get those up.
Yeah, I have one hit point left.
Drink that potion. No, not at this point. It won't matter.
Yeah.
31 does not hit you, correct?
Nope.
Okay, so 31 and then 30 does not hit you. So the two claws miss. This guy is going to be mad at you. Yeah, actually, he's just going to go with... He's going to try and do a bite.
Sure.
So, and that is an awful miss. All right, fuck it. He's just going to breath weapon you.
Sure.
He's not going to do the damage one, though. He's going to do breath of weakness. So give me a wisdom saving throw.
Hey, I can actually do these kind
magic.
Of magic. Yeah. Let me know if
you fail. Yeah, basically magic. For the sake, it's a breath weapon, so yeah.
So I have advantage, right?
Yep.
Oh, then I don't need to do anything.
22.
That's enough.
Sweet.
Poor guy. Okay, with his last bite, he's going to try and bite Jacobs.
How?
I mean, he's still flailing around. You're on top of him still, right?
Yeah, but I thought you said they couldn't get their necks all
the way. No, he can. It's just, it's really awkward for him. He looks really stupid, and that's their ego creatures.
Mm-hmm.
So... But sometimes you have to give away your ego to not die.
Yep.
Kill him with embarrassment. Make fun of him.
Yep. Does a 33 hit you?
Oh yeah, all day. Twice on Sunday.
So you take 21 points of piercing damage.
Fine, I'll have that.
Poor guy.
Oh, are we level fucking 20? I couldn't remember.
Not yet.
Okay, I wasn't sure. I got it all ready to do. I wasn't just...
Okay. No, I told you that presumably after today you probably will be.
Okay, that's what it was. I couldn't...
Assuming people survive and whatnot, so... Mm-hmm. That brings it to Rockstern.
And I'm really glad I did that Shadowfell thing. That's a good move.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was a really good move.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Man.
Rock's gonna start laughing.
Fucked.
Rock's gonna start laughing in this thing's face. How's it feel to be the first Sarushin forever to get your ass kicked
in all of existence?
And hit him again. 32.
That hits.
Hits him right in the ego.
12 points of radiant and 21 regular.
All right.
Second attack. Wrong button. Ah, only a 21 to hit.
Not enough.
Well, okay. But yeah,
he gained some self-confidence after he dodged that last one. He's like, I can still avoid you.
But yeah, Rock is just 100% laughing in this guy's face.
Oh yeah, and it's definitely getting to him.
All right. That's
like, there's three heads, and they're all, like, arguing with each other, basically, at this point. They're like, it's your fault. You should have moved out of the way. And he's like, no. He's like, well, you're getting in my way.
All right. Well, that's Rock's turn. He's done.
All right. Let's see. That brings it to Kenna.
My turn?
Yep.
Oh, boy.
Yeah,
I'm going kind of bad. I'm on fire, though, so that's a plus. Yes, my hit points double. To two.
You do not understand my power. In a matter of moments, I've doubled my health.
All right.
Six seconds.
Yeah, I'm...
By the way, you're pretty confident Zaladin can see you because he's just kind of ignoring you, but he's definitely looked at you as he landed on the ship.
I think he can, like...
Not interact with you, but he can see you. No.
Okay. Yeah.
Not likely. Not without shifting planes.
Yeah. All right, so the Dreadpool exists...
Only in the material plane only now.
Oh, okay.
That's why it's riding the waves.
Yeah.
And not, like, cutting through them materially.
Mm-hmm. Yep, it's no longer hovering. It's a boat currently.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, man.
And no one's on it to fire it.
Zaladin is.
Well, I mean, he can't fire an entire deck of cannons by himself. It's just a normal ship.
Oh, well, you're right. I'm just saying he can go individually and just shoot the cannons for funsies.
He's not going to do that.
Just to piss you off, he might.
I mean, he could do like more, like better things.
So. Yeah, that's what I mean. That's like, he's too smart. Unless he knows it would piss me off, in which case maybe he'll waste the time.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't really want to abandon the Dreadpool, but I don't really have any other option right now.
Well, I'm still in command of it as long as I have my hat.
You're right.
As long as you're within a mile of it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I need a quick. Timeout. So,
like for real? Like,
no. No, Kenna needs a timeout. This mountain right here, it's like a big volcano thing, right?
Correct.
Yeah, I want to go there.
Assumed.
Yeah.
Oh, you're like Superman inside a sun. Nice.
Yep, I'm gonna use my, the fucking book.
Lexicon of Worlds?
Lexicon of Worlds. I got it. I forgot the name of my artifact for a second.
You know too many things.
Yeah, I'm gonna use that to portal like above that freaking volcano and just like fall.
Yeah, I mean, like out of game, you've probably done this multiple times on this mountain in real life, so you could probably just go into the lava if you wanted to.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I'm okay with that.
The second you said that was a giant volcano, I was like, oh, spa day.
Yeah, I mean, I'm assuming Kenna has set up a spawn point there long ago.
So yeah, I'm just gonna go there and recharge a bit. By taking massive amounts of fire damage.
That's so awesome. Can't you open a portal to just Fire World?
Yeah, but it's not as efficient as as just basking in lava.
Okay.
If I let out, I can't let out that much raw energy. Okay. And if I could, it would probably be very bad for.
But I mean, couldn't you just could you just go in there? Like, you know how you go onto the plane of law and you just explode with good energy? Like is that the same thing? Or you could go
just to quickly like identify something. So in the Tomb of Annihilation, they actually cover lava damage because of submersion and stuff like that. You take 10d10 points of fire damage simplified to 55 fire damage around.
Okay.
And then if you're submerged, obviously you're supposed to, suffocate and all that, but your gods, whatever. Plane of Fire is actually more fire damage.
Okay, I think it's harder for me to go there, though. It takes more charges.
It does. I just want to let you know, I think it's 100 damage that you just flat take.
Okay.
Yeah, because it's just pure fire. If you choose to do that, because the Plane of Fire is not just fire. There is land masses and stuff.
Yeah,
so like depending where you go, but if you wanted to just go into an area of sheer fire, it would be 100 fire damage per round.
Let me just check real quick to see if I can.
Yep. I mean, you're teleporting somewhere. That could be your turn. You could figure it out.
You can figure out where you end up.
Yeah, you can go ahead and look that up.
Well, I could go to hell.
I'm going to take a really quick bio break.
Same.
Yeah, we could just go to hell. And I can teleport to Avernus.
Huh. Fair. I'm gonna take a quick break too. I'll be back in a minute.
Seems like not a great idea though.
Oh. So, where are you going? Hell or the Plane of Fire?
I wouldn't be able to go to the Plane of Fire and come back without using a lot more energy than I want to.
Oh, that's a shame.
All right. Is everyone back?
Yeah, I'm just going into the volcano.
Okay. Let's see. So that brings it to...
So that's something for the future, Kenna. Set up a waypoint in the Plane of Fire.
Yeah, I mean, I could use Plane Shift to go there, but I don't really want to use a 7th level spell. And the Lexicon of Worlds isn't queued in to go to the Plane of Fire. Maybe, I mean, I am... knowledge, like planar knowledge, so maybe I'll be able to more freely traverse the planes in the future.
That was the end of your turn, right?
Yep.
Okay, so that brings it back around to Saladin.
Okay, I'm back.
Oh, I guess he's still in the area, so he still takes the necrotic damage, right? Like, even though I'm not there, that still happens.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he takes...
Yeah, how long does that last again?
It's like 3 rounds. It's not very long.
Yep.
16 necrotic damage.
Okay.
Which is good, though, because it helps me heal.
All right. So... that brings to his turn. Check one thing really quick.
Yeah, so this round is the last round of that.
Okay. So, none of you guys can actually see what he's doing. So, I'm not going to do his turn publicly. Give me a second to write down what he's doing so I don't forget. Okay. So that brings it to three-headed Sarusha's turn. Very, 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 very much annoyed at this point. So he calls out for aid.
And Rohan.
The ghosts of Rohan. but in all seriousness, a shit ton of creatures come crawling out of every nook and cranny of the city as the city is being overrun. Granted, it hasn't been that long, so it's actually not that overrun at the moment, but you start seeing in the sky massive quantities of different creatures flying through the air towards you guys. So one of his actions is taking up calling for aid. One of them is going to try and blast Rock in the face with the breath weapon. Immune to the breath of weakness now. All right, so that is a dexterity saving throw.
The Suresh is attacking?
Yeah.
I thought I was after Zaladin.
Oh, I'm sorry. God, I'm really good at skipping you guys. Yes, it is your turn.
And I've only attacked this thing once so far. And yet, it's attacked Rock twice.
Did I skip you last turn then, too? Mm-hmm. Sorry, just go twice then.
Right. just shooting.
Okay.
With the super shot. Oh, all right. So first one got a 19 on the attack. Second one got a nat 20.
What's the totals on those? I'm saying, yeah, they should hit. Yeah.
I mean,
yeah. I was just, well, I was looking at a different number when you said that, and I'm like, that's not even close to that number. Then I'm like, that's not his AC.
Right.
If that was his AC, this would be a different game, and we wouldn't be playing D&D 5th edition.
I'm going to do this quickly then. So forward slash roll 10, 6. Okay, so that's. Hold on, then. D12. Okay. There's my 12s. Ugh. Okay, so 16 more. So that's 47 plus 21.
Isn't it plus 21 twice?
No, this is the first shot.
Oh.
So it's 47 plus 21 total?
Yep. So
68. Okay.
Okay, yep. So that was my skipped turn shot. Here comes this turn shot, and this turn shot was a crit.
Yep.
So, this will be fun.
Yeah, that'll be a fun thing to roll out.
Huh, not terrible. And then two more d12. Actually, no. It's 47. Ugh, and 7. I know 7 and 5. So 13. 13 more. So 79 plus. Does the sharpshooter? Or no. The sharpshooter doesn't trigger twice, just my ability damage. My dex damage, right?
Sharpshooter is just base damage, right?
Right.
Yeah, then no. Yeah, it's just dice that are doubled.
Yep. Oh, so the dex one does, your dex mod doesn't double as well? Because, like, the extra damage from dex?
I don't think so. I think it's just dice that are.
I'll
take a quick peek here.
21 on top of 77. No, I said 79. Yeah.
Yeah, it's extra dice damage.
Okay. 21 on top of 79, which is 80. So 100, straight up 100.
Very, very nice. So he has definitely got some cannon-sized holes in the back of his head.
Yeah.
not as cocky anymore.
Hey.
He's still kicking. He still looks.
I don't know what kind of deal you've made. But I'll make you another one right now if you want to get out of this fight.
Our deals can't be broken, but what are you offering?
Oh, well, I kind of knew they couldn't be broken, so I didn't really have one yet. I'll think about it on the next round if you're still alive.
Right. So then it's his turn,
assuming
you're done.
Yep.
Alright, so yeah, so one of the heads calls out for help still, because that's extra ouchy now. Second one is not actually going to blast you. He's actually going to blast your capital building with the breath weapon.
Oh.
So he's actually going to just run forward. He can actually... I keep forgetting to use his fucking bonus actions. God damn it. That's a big difference in his abilities. Frick.
I bet. I forgot what these things kind of want in their deals. Because I did talk with that other Suresh a little.
They have very mixed things.
Okay, so I'd have to find out what this one
they
is.
They prefer things with sentimental value.
Okay. So, yeah. Well, I mean, when he asked, what am I offering, I'd be like, what do you want?
That's not how Suresh deals work.
Mm.
They are mercenaries to those that truly need their help, so they offer something very valuable to them.
Oh.
They don't go out seeking contracts.
Yep, yep.
Yeah, so he has a pounce, which is a jumping away without provoking attack of opportunity. He's basically just going to jump towards your capital building and nuke it with his breath weapon.
Do I get to hang on?
Yeah, you can stay on, because he's not trying to get you off, so...
Good, that'd be
gross. You can come with. So then, breath weapon, call for help, so that's two. So second one is going to... or the third head is going to try and bite you. Does a 32 hit?
Oh yeah, it's still on Sunday.
Okay, 21 damage then.
Oh my god, exact same. I think it was a 31 last time, or 32 last time, and 21 damage as well. So
yep.
I'm going to have that.
Okay. And then he's got... He, claw attacks cannot reach you. So...
Quit fucking up my city!
At that, he begins to burrow.
No!
So actually, I do need you to make a acrobatics check to hang on, because he's now using his remaining moves to try and get you off. And he digs fast, so roll well, my young lad.
All right. What is it?
Dex acrobat or
acro?
No, it's dexterity saving throw would be.
Oh, dex saving. Okay.
Or, I mean, it could be acrobatics. Actually, that'd make more sense realistically, because you're just trying to like avoid being crushed underneath the rubble that he's digging through.
40.
Yeah, you're fine.
Whoa.
You hear him muttering like, "Get off me!
Quit! Get out of my city!
I'll sink your city."
Oh, you better not.
I mean, like, that's probably okay. You're the god of the ocean.
Yeah,
right?
You don't. I'll make an Atlantis.
That'd actually be pretty sweet under underwater island.
Yep.
Underwater pirate island.
Yep.
Yeah.
I'd be like, that'd be awesome. Go ahead.
Actually, that gives me a good idea.
Yeah.
All right, now you owe me. That was my deal.
All right.
So Rock, you're up.
I'll give you my most treasured smithy.
They're all gonna be dead soon.
Okay, so
they're always dead.
I have one smithy that I just never yell at, and I give him like gifts and praise him, and all the other ones hate him.
Yep.
First of all, how close is this guy? Like, how far was his pounce?
So his pounce was 40 feet.
Okay.
And then he can dig 40 feet, so he's technically 80 feet away.
Oh, holy dick.
Alright, how close are all these animal monstrosities?
They're not. Most of them are not animals.
Shit.
He knows you're the god of nature, so he didn't call the animals.
he sounded creepy.
That was gonna be my thing. Is
yeah, I mean they're god slayers. They know who you guys are.
And you know he's smart.
Yep. Hey, his intelligence of 22.
Ooh.
All right. Well, fuck it. I run the 40 feet and hop in the hole.
Awesome. Right, you see him. you see him. You just like jump in. And you see him digging a hole straight down. Well, it's not straight down. It's at like a very sharp angle. I mean, if you just want to, like, yeah, I was going to say, if you just want to, like, lunge yourself down the hole and slide down, and you'd probably hit him. Not, like, to deal damage, but...
Yeah, that's what I wanted to do. It's just, yeah. Like, get out
jump.
Me.
Yeah, you're jumping and going sledding.
Hey, Rock!
Yeah.
It's round two, huh?
No quarry escapes me.
It's like your parasites.
Been called worse by better.
Yeah.
Alright, anything else in your turn? Is that it?
No, that's it.
Alright, so Kenna, you're up. Just gonna bathe in lava?
I've been called worse, but not by better.
I think while I'm here, I'm going to
eat some fire.
Summon my portal and
drink that potion.
That would have could do fire damage though.
It's already a fucking quarter.
Well, I'm already immune to it. It's just however much damage I would take. I'm already immune, so it doesn't matter. Yeah. It's not quartered though, because the Shadowfell thing is in here.
I'll say is the potion gives you resistance to all damage for an hour. Is the only thing.
Right. Yeah.
And that 100 psychic would have been 50.
That's true. That would have been good.
It's why I live so long, honestly. All right. Without them, I'd be dead ages ago.
Zeldin takes 10 necrotic damage as the portal and the shadow effect is gone.
He's not in the area anymore.
Okay. Well, I do know that then.
That's
good. okay, so yeah, I'm going to summon my portal here and channel the power of the nine hells through it to give myself like devil wings in exchange for the extra armor.
Fancy.
I want to be able to fly. And then yeah, I just am on fire.
Perfect. All right.
That's my turn.
All right. So, let's see here. Moving back on over to Zaladin.
Get out of here, Zaladin. Get out of here. Take your creatures and go the fuck away.
So, Jacobs, you have pretty good perception, right?
Yeah. Do I know someone's on my ship? Do I have, like, the whole, someone's on my ship?
I mean, not anymore. Like, you sense that he left your ship.
Okay.
But you still feel something wrong with your ship. I do want to point that out.
Damn it.
That's how this all began.
Yeah. We got interrupted.
Mm-hmm. I had some shit to figure out, some personal problems.
Yeah.
I know, it's
this
great.
This asshole just comes by throwing Santa Claus.
Yeah, throwing Santas at us.
From the moon.
Mm-hmm. Motherfucker.
So, Rock, how good's your perception? Is it mediocre? Is it good?
It's a plus 8. Like, it's okay.
Oh, I mean, that's not bad. Okay, why don't you both give me a perception check? You both have capabilities.
Mine is 16.
Yeah, I know yours is awesome. That's why I wasn't even going to have you roll, but yeah. Just both roll.
Okay. Hey, well, 29.
I noticed nothing. I have a 16.
16, and what'd you get?
29.
Jacob? Perfect. So, like, you think you feel an earthquake.
That better not be you.
The Suresh is like, not me. I'm just trying to get out of here, and you guys won't leave me alone.
Oh, you are? You're trying to leave?
Not at the moment, yes.
Well, why did you say so? That was going to be part of the deal. Is you fucking leave, and don't destroy my city, and something, something, something.
Well, how about you go check out whatever that was, and I'll leave.
Yeah, all right, deal.
So, yeah, I mean, that's so...
It'd be more helpful if you could, you know, bring us back up there.
That's not part of the deal.
I know. I said it would be more helpful.
So, that was Saladin's turn. This is Jacob's turn.
All right.
So now it's your turn officially, so...
What do I see? Oh, my turn officially, or...?
Yeah, it's your turn officially.
Can I see up through the hole, or...?
No. You're, like, you can't see shit. Like, so, to clarify, he dug, like, down...
Yeah.
And then he dug at an angle. So it's like a drop platform, then dangle down.
Okay, so...
Specifically, he was trying to stop any of you from standing on top of the hole and shooting him in the face.
Oh, okay.
So blocking line of sight was part of the plan.
Yep. I will... I will real quick ask this Rush. Why is Zaladin even here?
1 second. Kenna, you can, because it's the damage is like 10d10, just go ahead and take the 100 points of damage because you're willingly sacrificing yourself to the fire.
Okay.
Wait, sorry, what were you saying, Jacob?
Right before I, like, well, before I go, why is this Zaladin asshole even here, attacking my city?
I have no idea.
Oh, I barely fucked with him.
My job was to lead the army if he fought, and here I was.
Ah.
But
I see.
I got the go ahead to leave, so I'm leaving.
Thanks. All right, and I run out of this hole. Okay. Is it 40 down?
Yeah.
All right, so I've got 30 speed.
I mean, you could bonus action just use your hook to get up top.
But that's what I mean. Like, can I, like, 30?
Yeah. So, like here. I'll do like a little freehand draw just to kind of clarify like what it looks like.
Zoomed in at the southern hook.
Yeah. So like, it's like down, and then like that. So you could just teleport to the top of the hill and then just jump out because it's only like a 5 foot down.
All right. It's just I wanted to save the hook for when I'm out there if I needed to go somewhere.
Oh, yeah, so if you need to get somewhere quick, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it would take you a full 45 to get out of it. But for 40 would put you at the top like of where you sink in.
Yep.
So you'd be able to look out physically.
All right, so either way, it's going to take my double like a double move, but then I have bonus to hook somewhere.
Or remember, I was going to say, remember, you have your, I guess your bonus would be your hook then, though, so.
Yep. That's yeah.
But I mean, you could use your hook as a move action, so you could just run up there with your double, and then hook if you needed to.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because as like your move action, you could just take your standard like your normal action and convert that into movement. Because either way, you're moving half speed up this because you're climbing actually.
Oh, okay.
So you could just use your full, yeah, whatever they call it, where you convert it to movement.
All right. So I'm out of this hole, and I'm looking around for biggest threat and or if Kenna needs a hand.
So the biggest threat is definitely the big-ass explosion in the center of your town, okay, which is right next to where you're at, basically. So you see that there are several buildings that are just, like, being crushed under an invisible Jesus weight, essentially.
Christ, what now?
And then you see Zaladin floating up in the sky, just like basically using his hand to like crush your city.
What?
Clearly using a power.
Okay, well, I don't hook directly under him then.
Using your gravitation powers.
Yep.
No.
How? So is he just floating in the sky?
Oh, I mean, he's quite a ways up in the sky, too. He's
can I
definitely using divine powers to
talk the ship with the reindeer?
Mean, presumably they wouldn't have hung around unless you wanted them to.
Right. I assume they took off, but they can teleport.
Yeah.
Can't they, or do I have to do that?
You can call them, but then they would appear in the middle of the town.
Oh, I can't.
If that's where you want them.
I would want them way up above.
Tell the reindeer to have everyone in the world sing jolly Christmas songs and charge up a massive
spirit bomb.
Oh, yes. the spirit of Christmas bomb.
Yep.
I need to make that.
By the power of Christmas.
Yep.
Spirit.
I guess I would want them to teleport, like, a mile.
No, like if you call them, they come to you.
Okay, then that, yeah.
Like they basically appear in front of you.
Yep, nope, don't want
in
that.
In the nearest space.
Don't want that. Because I don't want them to get involved in this.
Oh, yeah. Not a great spot.
No. All right, well, then I just go kind of nearest building that isn't being completely destroyed.
Oh, I mean, like you're at like the epicenter of it pretty much. So like, unless you like actively go away, you're going to start feeling this shit soon.
Oh, well, like, then I will
move. You're in, like, the center of town, like, nearing the center of town.
All right, then, yeah, I move back a little bit with the hook. I just attach to the random roof.
You're like, Rock, you might want to come see this.
Rock, he's fucking my town up. Come headbutt him again. And, yeah, I go to just some random building on the a little bit outside the destruction.
Okay.
And so now, with all of that rigmarole that was said, can I still shoot? I don't think I can.
No.
Okay, right. I didn't think so. That's what I got out of it.
Either way, you're what's your gun's range?
I don't know. Probably 100. Let me look.
Yeah, I mean, he's nowhere near that. He'd be way out of your range.
Gotcha. Yep.
We'll just say you could just fire just for the sake of being angry.
I'm trying to get his attention. Hey, quit that shit! I shoot at him.
So that brings it to Sarush. He's just gonna keep digging away. Rock, you're up.
Oh, actually, 240. So that's pretty good. But still.
Yeah, still not enough. That is pretty good.
Rock has no idea what to do.
Get the hell out here and go kick his ass.
Alright, well, I guess I'll fly in his direction, but...
What's the speed on your boots?
30.
Ick.
No, it's 40. It's my walking speed, so 40.
Yeah, so you can get to the top of the hill, the tunnel, just like Jacob's was. So you're basically using your movement. You're at the top of the hill, or the tunnel.
Cool. I'm gonna yell really loud, "Hey, could you fucking not?"
Mm-hmm.
And that's about it.
I mean, I do love that, but he definitely can't hear you under the sound of the buildings crushing and collapsing.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I can't hear you over the sound of me destroying this city.
Yeah.
It's like, what the fuck are you doing? What do you want?
So we're actually at the perfect point where I was not... Okay, this sounds awful. This is where I was hoping to get to.
What, with my city being destroyed?
So I have, like... This took me a while to figure out where I was going to go with the story, and this is kind of...
What the hell are we even doing?
Yeah,
I don't even know what's going on.
That's exactly it. That's exactly what I wanted.
There's way too much shit going on.
Yep, exactly.
I mean, so I don't mind chaos, but yeah, all of a sudden now my shit's getting destroyed.
So my favorite part about this is that it's I threw things your way to see how you guys reacted. You guys reacted in a way that got to a point where one of the storylines I was hoping to get to, and we're gonna roll with that. Unless you guys say otherwise, we're gonna do a bit of a cutscene here. Hey. I don't like doing cutscenes, but this is a good scenario for it.
I mean, there's nothing we can fucking do about it.
Aside from leaving, yes, that's
I ain't leaving.
That's exactly what I was assuming you would say, so that's why I have this cutscene thing kind of I brought it up.
I Mike understands the consequences and knows what can happen, but Jacob's no. I don't give a fuck. This is my place. I am dying here.
Yeah. So okay. So.
But I do intend to come back as soon as, like, in a couple of rounds, as soon as I have reasonable amount of hit points.
Exactly. So are you guys okay with cutscening with those ideas in mind?
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Okay. So. Pause just for a second. Dramatic pause. Mm-hmm. And I just realized this entire time I did not have music going. And I had music set up for this.
Yeah, me too.
Okay, good. So
it's just weird not, like, hearing nothing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no. It really is. So, over the course of the next 48 hours are probably the most intense moments of your lives. You are three extremely egotistical, extremely diehard survivors against literally impossible odds, against someone who can alter reality to his will. You do not stand a chance against an intermediate deity. It's just that simple. He has the power to literally sink this island if he so chooses.
You better not.
Not do it. Atlantis.
His destruction of the center of your town was more of a statement. Over the course of several hours of you doing everything you can to attack him, he more of toys with you at this point. It's become a game to him in a sense that he wants you to understand how out of your league you are. He had no intention of fighting you guys coming here. He came actually to kill Chris Claus and absorb his divine ranks to get even further ahead of you guys. After about 6 hours of dreaded combat, Jacobs realizes that he can't even dent Zaladin's plans. So pleading with Kenna and Rock to figure something out, you come to the realization that because there's no domain for Chris Claus can't technically die, so he could be resurrected. Your other option would be to, as Chris Claus, and having his current powers at your whim. You could temporarily give up the Southern Hook domain and create a new domain under the guise of Santa, essentially. Giving Chris Claus a true domain where you could bring him and slay him yourselves to absorb his divine ranks. You've already got his blessing to do so. He told you, Jacob, straightforward that he cast a ritual that brought him to the one being that could carry on his legacy, and it was you.
But I'd have to lose the hook.
Well, hold on. No, you wouldn't. You could go back to it. It'd be a temporary loss. And that's, you know, that's obviously your own thing of your inner turmoil. You have discussed in the past about passing on the reins of Dread Pirate. Now would be your time to do that. And you could take on the mantle of essentially Santa.
Damn it.
I'm not saying you have to. I am simply pointing out a fact that you guys could do. The other option would be is you guys could flee. Fleeing would essentially grant... I mean, he would sink the Southern Hook most likely if you guys fled, including the Dreadpool. The Dreadpool not being currently the full Dreadpool, you do not know if it would come back or not. There's a lot of mysteries to that. You're just unsure. It might just come right back like normal. Exactly. I apologize as a player, as a person.
No, that's fine. I can roll.
Story-wise, this worked out fairly well in terms of being a dramatic moment.
Pretty much anything.
So 48 hours pass and you dwell on different tactics and you guys end up at a lone tavern. This is kind of a hidden sanctuary where Jacobs has set up. Rosalina, Ileana, Garen, and Pan are all here.
Oh.
After they managed to coax her. I forgot to put Pan on here, but Pan's here too. Rosalina is a performer, so is Ileana, and Solas is up there just performing. Fire goes in the fireplace, and Kenna sits nearby the music, and Solas, Jacobs, and Rock are playing darts and throwing weapons. Garen sits at the bar, watching over everyone, making sure there's no one sneaking in. You have a decision to make of what you'd like to do. This is the final hours of the 48 hours of terror and exhaustion. Like, you guys can't get exhausted, but you are...
mentally.
I mean, you are essentially... Like what we just did, you're doing that for 48 hours.
Yep.
This is the last hour where you have to make a decision, where you realize that you guys could heal all you want. At the end of the day, he's going to either heal faster or he's just going to outpower you. So at this point, you're left with a decision of what you'd like to do. As a DM, I'm not going to force any decision on you. I know this is a rough situation to put you in.
The only thing, like, honestly, I'm all for everything. And like, I'll do it in character too. I just don't want to lose my title of Dread Pirate.
Oh, I mean, you don't have to give that up. Like, the only reason why that it would make sense for you to lose that title is that's a really awful title for Santa.
I know, but Dread Pirate Santa? Oh, that'd be awesome. And I'm saying
it's
that too while drinking.
Dread Christmas now.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean.
But it's still good old jolly Christmas, but Dread Pirate Santa, you know.
Yes, everyone sing and be merry. Or else.
Yeah, exactly. So Holonoxian number two.
Right.
So we have second Halloween.
But that way me and Holonoxian would have some like equal ground. We could hang out at like, you know, during holidays and shit. And
oh, like as a side note, Holonoxian and you would totally get along.
Yeah.
Especially if you killed Chris Claus. He hates Chris Claus. So
that's right. I think he does.
Spice.
All right. So I'm just getting hammered. Because I've already decided like to do everything, and I'm just all upset and salty that I have to give up my island even temporarily. And
then... I mean, you could technically not give up your island, and you could actually just make that the temporary domain of Chris Claus. That's the other option.
No, because then what if right after I kill Chris, then dude shows up here and kills me?
Possible.
Yeah.
So, hear me out. Take it from somebody who's survived a pretty catastrophic war and impending doom in an entire realm. What is lost can be rebuilt by the survivors. So the hook can be rebuilt bigger and better. Humankind is a resilient species. They bounce back fast. There was a saying when I was a man that a man cannot be broken like an animal, like a horse or a dog. The harder you beat him, the taller he stands. So, while a temporary loss, maybe it's better to let him have Chris Claus, get him in the end.
Oh, so yeah, suggesting we just resurrect Chris and let him take his power. We go.
I mean, it's not an ideal solution, but it gets him off our back long enough for us to come up with a plan. I mean, there's gotta
be. We give him more power, this will only get worse.
Yeah, that is his plan, is to take his power.
I see what you understand, or I see what you mean, Rock. And for what it's worth, Jacobs, I'm sorry that this happened.
No.
I will admit I may have been a bit reckless in that negotiation.
It's all right.
But I am tired of that man existing. His arrogance has spanned millennia, and he has caused no end of trouble because of it. I would rather die than bow to someone as reckless and irreverent as him. I'm sorry only that I implicated you with me in that.
Well, it's all right. It's no need. Apparently I acted brazenly and acquired the thing that he was here for, so his target switched to
me. My strategy here, I think, and I don't know if this is the right decision, but I think it would be better if we stopped trying to play his game, his grand schemes spanning centuries. As good as I am at such things, I will admit, he has done it for longer. My idea is an old fae strategy of, they call it instilling bedlam. But what it means is simply wreak havoc with no regret. And
that sounds like a pirate strategy.
Hope that you hurt your enemy more than you hurt yourself.
I like it.
Take everything that he wants. Try and stop everything he does for no reason other than because he wants it.
I like it. I mean,
it's not something that I've tried very often, but maybe that is my problem.
Well, I slam my ale, or whatever I was drinking. My Dreadpool spirits.
Whatever it is you want.
Yep. and
hot cocoa with marshmallows right now.
Yep. Yeah, that's right. I'm like, for some reason, get me some cookies and milk.
It could be eggnog.
There you go.
Compromise. Really, really hard eggnog.
Yep.
So that being said, I think my judgment is somewhat affected, so I would abdicate the final decision of this to either of you two. That's just my input.
Well, I had the Christmas hat sitting on the table, and so I get up, put the hat on, and say, "God damn it, I'm bringing Christmas back." Let's get that cause back to his pole so I can murder him in cold blood.
Garen stands up and kind of walks over and puts his hand on your shoulder. There's a sense of ease that comes about you as he says, "There are no easy big decisions."
No.
His claws was quite powerful. He more than likely had enough power within him to share with one of your companions. I feel one of you. He looks over at Rock, who is currently the most powerful of the group here.
Yeah.
I feel if you were to abstain from absorbing some of the power, Kenna and Jacobs could probably share what he had.
Oh no, absolutely.
That being said, I feel as though you three are on the brink of being able to challenge him. The rest of us seem to be playing as pawns in this game without a real set to play with. I, Lord Garen, formally give up my divine ranks.
Oh, shit.
I bestow my power upon you three. My role as a god of the heavens is not a fitting one for my station. I have always been a guardian and a protector. I am not a leader. Even as a god, I followed your command without any thought of my own will. I fear I am not in the position to make the decisions needed. There's one other that has brought this to my attention as well, and he would like to speak up. Walking through the door is none other than your buddy, Greg Mahler. I hereby give up my stupid rank to you idiots. Same thing he said. My goals aren't in line with what need to be done, and in all honesty, this whole divine thing is getting in the way of some of my plans. So take them and be done with it.
I understand your plight, to be honest. Before this, I had much more time to study things.
Yes, well.
Before this, shut up. I had a fucking city.
He says, I do want to point out that I still need your aid, Kenna.
And I will give it.
Hopefully these powers will be a little more useful to you than me. I do want to warn all of you something, though. There are things awakening throughout the multiverse that are more dangerous than we're giving them credit for. The little one there, watch her closely. While Zaladin is a problem, I fear she's worse. And he kind of, you see the black and red energy flow out of him, and morph up with the white and gold of Garen's as it gives each one of you a divine rank.
So, and
as you guys continue your plot to bring Chris Claus to the North Pole, presumably you're going to his house. Is that what I was getting out of that, Jacobs?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Where you slay him. That will leave Rock with one extra divine rank and Jacob.